führt dazu, dass thermische Kraftwerke von den Erzeugungskosten höher sind. Ich habe also von Kunden gehört, die Dampfkraftwerke haben, nach 2/3 der prognostizierten Lebensdauer haben sie schon das Lebensdauerende erreicht, aufgrund der neuen Anforderungen bezüglich der Fahrweise.
Now, why do we have a superior flexibility with gas engines? First of all, one of the few techniques, if not the only technique, that can be ready to synchronize in 30 seconds only. Reaching 100% of load in 5 minutes from complete standstill is not seen in the technology otherwise. And then it doesn't matter if you have 10 megawatts, 100 megawatts, or 200 megawatts of gas-fired multi-engine power generation.
Why are Wärtsilä's power plants more feasible and profitable?
So Wärtsilä's power plants are more feasible because they are more flexible. So we can offer on more markets and earn more money on different markets like balancing, heat markets, intraday and day ahead, for example. And this makes them even more prepared for the future and more profitable.
And this is even creating more flexibility. Never use one single big power plant, use multiple power plants or smaller units on a row. We call this a cascading system. If you need them, if you need more power because there is not a lot of wind or sunshine, you switch them all on. If you don't need them all because there is a lot of wind and sunshine, just switch maybe 8 of them off and you still have very high performing engines running and creating stability in the system.